by the John Tabahiri. The outer question is a matter of life and death. The soldier is voicing his concern about thrashing his son received from security operatives a night before. John cannot walk and requires a car to move for his son to get treatment at the National Referral Hospital of Mulago. He requires an authorization to move. He says he's been denied one. With all his clothes and medication carried in his bag, he has promised not to leave until his concerns are addressed. The RDC of Entebbe means there has been delay in attending to John.
Yesterday, information that his son was beaten by our security people, the RDOs. But he was given a permission, and that permission was given to him yesterday to take his son to the hospital.
People seeking clearance to use emergency government vehicles in Entebbe are accusing authorities of charging them for fuel costs.
They put their patients in cars, but up to now, we haven't moved. Nothing has been done. They told them to at least get some money to put in fuel in the cars, in the government cars.
Some say they have their own vehicles fueled, but they have been denied access to the road.
But already we had put the fuel in our own cars. So we are just here waiting to see how we shall be helped.
The RDC in response says they have the emergency cars, but government failed to facilitate them has not been delivered.
Right now we don't have fuel, though we have the vehicles. But if really you have some little money you fuel the vehicle, which can take.
Uganda is on its seventh day of the lockdown as a measure to prevent the spread of COVID-19. Kaman Ivan Wanyoro, NTV.